Welcome back to Billions, and it's season 5, episode 5.
I can't approve this just yet. There's another bank representing that zone.
Axelrod wants to open a bank, but there's a problem.
Vark?
The response from the lawyer should be, who cares? There's no postcode monopoly. Instead, he says,
isn't even FDIC insured?
Technically, that can be correct. If Vark Bank takes deposit, then it is FDIC insured. Never mind. The Axe team decides to trick Vark.
We're so in love. Can't wait to settle down. We're hoping you can help us with a home loan.
We're prepared to offer you 8.5%.
We'll discover that bank will offer a mortgage at a rate of 8.5% to a gay foreign couple.
That's way above prime.
We can lock you in at 2.8%.
Versus 2.8% for a middle-aged white guy. And the conclusion is,
xenophobia, homophobia, racism. Can serve them up all three.
But is that really the case? And what can be done about it? So we're going to take the side of Vark Bank. Is it because they are not white or gay? That could have influenced the decision, but what he talks about,
you're not great credit risks.
Which is a fair point. That raises the issue of financial inclusion. If the bank doesn't have information on you, how can it lend you some money?
No one else will even give you this. And did you say your countries?
If they're not US citizens, the perceived risk could simply be a lack of credit history. So one fintech solution for that is open banking. Just like you can convert your money, your banking history and data should be transportable between financial institutions and between countries, and you should have control over it. Now, why does he get a good rate? Is it because they look the same? Or maybe he's got a large deposit, great credit history, very high income? The issue is here equality, and studies show that race has an impact.
When I was buying an apartment in the city, sometimes it's better to let your white fiancé from Riverdale do all the talking.
And studies show that race has an impact. So one way to solve this is to not include race or sex or looks in the application. So what about not going to the bank? It's 2020, you can do it online, and the services are provided by various fintech. First, you need secure identification. Then, you need digital services, and with machine learning algorithm, you can determine much better the risk profile and therefore what rate should apply. So that's how Vark can fight back with the help of financial technology. They can be the bank for a global migrant community online. They can specialize in that. They use open banking for mortgage application, using data from any country to build a credit history, and machine learning to define the risk profile and appropriate rate. And they could fight back by looking at the Axe Capital team here. Can you see what could be missing? Well, the issue is representation and diversity. Where's this lady from episode 1?
Baby boomers. They're getting old, so they're getting sick. When the group reports patient volumes, it's gonna overshoot street expectation.
That kicked ass, but just lasted one episode.
Back up!
So if you're a community bank, there are plenty of options offered by fintech to modernize and fight back against a big hedge fund like Axe Capital. I hope you've enjoyed this exploration of fintech and finance. Please subscribe and also let me know if there's any other episode or series of films that you'd like to see analyzed.